Hello everyone, in this video, I will explain in detail how RouterSocks 5 works, provide specific usage instructions, and guide you on how to accurately check for IP spoofing. As I mentioned in previous videos, RouterSocks 5 is an anti-detect router system when you use a proxy. In simple terms, we will assign a proxy to this router and any device connected via network cable or Wi-Fi to it will use the proxy IP according to the most accurate parameter settings. Now, I will guide you through the two simplest ways to provide a network connection to the router. Method 1, you will connect a network cable from the LAN port of your home networking device. Into the WAN port on the RouterSocks 5. You can connect directly from the ISP modem, an external networking device, or even from a network switch. Remember, the network connection for RouterSocks 5 must always be plugged into the WAN port. Method 2, use an LTE 4G or 5G SIM card. This method is suitable for those who frequently travel, live in apartments, or in situations where your home internet is weak. You just need to insert the SIM card into this SIM slot, making sure to insert it in the correct orientation like this. The four antennas in the middle are for Wi-Fi, and the two antennas on the sides are for boosting the LTE signal. Next, I will guide you in detail on how to use the management software and clearly explain the features of the router. Our management software supports two languages, Vietnamese and English, with the features and usage being the same in both languages. Therefore, in this video, I will guide you through the management software using the Vietnamese language interface. First, we need to add the router's address and the router's name to the management list. Then, click on Add Router. You can add multiple routers that you want to control for easier management. The Delete Router option will remove a specified router from the list. The Clear All option will remove all routers from the list. Next, add the proxy to the list. You can use SOCKS5, HTTP/HTTPS, WireGuard, or OpenVPN. I will add a few examples to the list. Leave the username and password fields blank if they are not required. After entering the information, click on Add Proxy to add it to the list. For example, to add a WireGuard connection to the list. If there is a pre-shared key, enter it, if not, leave it blank. For example, To add an OpenVPN connection to the list, click on the Select File box and then choose the OpenVPN file you want to connect. If there is a username or password, enter them, otherwise, leave them blank. For example, to add a SOCKS5 connection to the list, delete proxy, remove a specified proxy from the list. Check proxy, verify the status of the proxy. If the status shows green, it means the proxy is stable and ready to connect. If the status shows red, it means the proxy is down or experiencing issues. Please check the proxy. Server 1 and Server 2 are two servers with different connection algorithms and bypass systems. Server 1 has a connection algorithm and bypass system that is quite stable. It balances both speed and security. Server 2, Method 1 has a connection algorithm that prioritizes speed. Server 2, Method 2 has a connection algorithm that prioritizes quality. Depending on your needs, if you want to bypass the strictest checks, you should choose Server 2 Method 2. Anti-tracking feature. Anti-tracking acts as an invisible shield that protects your every move on the internet. The technology is designed to block all attempts to track users' online activities by advertisers, analytics companies, and even internet service providers. When you enable this feature, your personal information, such as browsing history, geographical location, and internet usage habits, will not be collected. We have also coded additional blocks to prevent systems from sending texts and unnecessary connections such as Akamai, ThreatMetrics, Windows Telemetry, Windows Update, and many other systems. Our system uses advanced machine learning algorithms to analyze and detect potential tracking behaviors. These algorithms continuously learn and evolve, ensuring that no matter how sophisticated tracking techniques become, our anti-tracking feature always stays one. But we don't stop at just blocking tracking. Anti-tracking also has the capability to protect you from fingerprinting, a technique used by websites to identify you based on your device configuration, browser, and other factors. This is achieved by creating fake or random digital fingerprints that deceive tracking systems, making it extremely difficult, if not impossible, to determine your identity. Obfuscation DNS ensures that all your DNS queries are obfuscated and encrypted. This helps prevent third parties, including ISPs and analytics companies, from snooping on your internet activity. No matter where you are or what you're doing, obfuscation DNS guarantees that your journey on the internet remains safe and anonymous. Specifically, obfuscation DNS can 1. Prevent DNS tracking, makes DNS queries difficult to detect or analyze by external parties. 2. Protect against DNS hijacking, achieved through a multi-layer authentication check, using continuously updated encryption certificates. 3. Enhance security and anonymity by obfuscating DNS queries, not just by encryption. We also use techniques like query splitting and dynamic routing to ensure that each DNS query is sent through multiple different servers, creating complexity and making it difficult for anyone to track your overall activity. Main DNS, DNS from the proxy's ISP. Secondary DNS helps you improve speed and enhance query performance. Connect proxy. After clicking to connect the proxy, you will need to wait for 1 minute. During this time, the router will connect to the proxy and then check parameters such as IP address, country, region, city, ISP, time zone. Stop proxy, disconnect the proxy to use your original IP. Fake router. In the fake router section, select the router brand you want to spoof. Then, click on Random MAC to get the parameters of the new router. The copy feature allows you to quickly copy MAC parameters so that you can restore the router to its previous settings if desired. If you want to restore the previously changed router settings, select the Customize option and enter the saved parameters. Click on Change Router to start applying the new settings to the entire router. This process will take about 3 minutes. During this time, the router will apply the fake router settings you have chosen, along with all the proxy parameters that were previously checked. A few important notes to remember. When the countdown timer is running, do not issue a command that overlaps the previous one. While the timer is counting down, it is advisable to turn off Wi-Fi on devices like computers and phones. Wait until the countdown reaches zero. And here is the result after the IP has been spoofed using our device. WebRTC and the IP address are the same. DNS V4 and V6 are standard from the ISP of the service provider. Additionally, I will guide you on how to check if the IP spoofing parameters are accurate. We will continue by checking the parameters on a mobile phone. Connect to the Wi-Fi network of RouterSocks5.net. First, we will check with it binding.online. The result is excellent. Next, we will check with fv.pro. Currently, fv.pro is the most accurate and best system for checking available today. The provided parameters are excellent, with a fraud warning of 0, and fv.pro cannot detect that we are using a proxy. Remember, we started developing this technology in 2021, and by now, we have many years of experience. The technology is continuously updated every month. With a large number of customers and as a pioneer in anti-detect router technology, others are merely imitating us and do not have the expertise. Recently, many customers have reported that numerous companies are imitating our technology and continuously launching low-quality products. You should be cautious. A sincere piece of advice, if you want a good product in this field, ask for test results from the website fv.pro before making a purchase. If the results are good, then proceed with the purchase. Now, we will test the internet speed when the proxy is spoofed using our device. Currently, it's raining outside, so my internet speed is quite slow. In good weather conditions, the speed can go over 100 megabits per second. The video review and guide conclude here. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next videos.